Chapter number 8. Natural Resources. Water, land, air, sunlight, forests, animals, and minerals are natural resources. They are gifted to us by nature and are used by us to stay alive. Natural resources are called the wealth of a nation because countries with more variety of natural resources like minerals, oil, gas, and petroleum can use them to generate revenue. Early humans did not realize the value or importance of these natural resources. However, slowly they learned to modify them into useful things. Now, times have changed and human beings are destroying these natural resources by overusing them. They are clearing forests to build factories, industries, or houses. As a result of our wants, we are killing forest life and destroying the woods to make space for every increasing human population. This overuse of natural resources is making the countries poorer as the resources are getting exhausted. Kinds of natural resources. Natural resources are of two types, renewable and non-renewable resources. Renewable resources are also called inexhaustible resources. These resources can be replenished. Sunlight, water, and air are called renewable natural resources. It is interesting to note that plants and animals are also renewable resources. Air is an important renewable resource. Life is not possible without air. In fact, all living beings require air to breathe. Water is also equally important. It is used for drinking, cooking, washing, and for growing crops. Water energy is also being harnessed for generating electricity. Plants give us food and oxygen. All types of animals depend on plants for food. Trees are homes to many animals, insects, and birds. They provide shelter, fresh air, and prevent soil erosion. Medicines are made from the roots, leaves, and even barks of some trees. Hence, they are known as green gold. Soil is also an important resource because crops are grown in it. We depend on soil for food, clothing, and shelter. Soil conservation should also be our goal as it sustains plant life. Natural resources should be wisely used. For example, water should be used carefully. As we know, rainwater adds to the underground water reserves. However, overuse and wastage of this water will create shortage everywhere. Windmills are being set up to generate electricity. Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra, Gujarat, Karnataka, Rajasthan, Kerala, and West Bengal are states that are taking lead in setting up windmills. Non-renewable resources. Non-renewable resources are available in limited quantity. Once they are exhausted, like metals, coal, and petroleum, they cannot be replaced. These resources are also called exhaustible resources. For example, metal are found deep inside the earth and in limited quantity. Since ancient times, metals are used for making household utensils, tools, weapons, and ornaments. Similarly, coal is used as a fuel to cook, heat, and generate electricity. It is used to run steam engines, factories, etc. It is also used in the production of glass, cement, and steel. India is rich in coal reserves, but it is depleting rapidly. Petroleum is also called black gold because of its importance in our life. It is refined to make petrol, kerosene, and diesel. These are used as fuel in vehicles, public transport, factories, industries, etc. It is also used for production of plastics, fertilizers, detergents, paints, pesticides, etc. Oil reserves are also limited. Nowadays, as the natural resources are being overused, researches are being conducted to harness alternative energy sources. Solar energy is one such source of energy. It is rightly described as the resource of the future. Solar energy is being used for cooking and even lighting. Advanced countries like Japan are developing cars that are run by solar energy. In India, biogas plants are being successfully used in rural areas as fuel for cooking. We need to conserve our forests and wild animals, as our careless attitude has led to the extinction of many species. We need to conserve our natural resources and use them judiciously.